Let me go across to my colleague Disha Shah, who's joining me live from the South Mumbai constituency, getting us those updates there. Disha, first of all, tell us where you are and what has been the kind of voter turnout. Remember, in the past, we have also spoken about a very low-key campaigning that had taken place across Maharashtra. So tell us, what is the kind of voter turnout? Do you see people coming out in large numbers and casting their vote there?
Well, Apoorva, right now I'm in Pedder Road, where big names, corporate names, industrialists are expected to come out and vote, like the Ambanis, the Godrej. All of them are expected to come out later in the afternoon. But at this point in time, we have seen since morning, very less number of people have actually come out on the streets to the voting, to the polling center to cast their vote, is what we understand. If I can ask my video journalist Kapil to show you, in almost most of the polling centers, they have now this facility of wheelchair as well, where you know, senior citizens, especially people with disabilities, can actually go sit on this wheelchair and they can actually go to the polling center. So this is, of course, the kind of arrangements that have been made at the polling center. But if you talk about the low-key of a voter turnout last elections as well, Apoorva, we had seen that this particular constituency, South Mumbai constituency, which is spread right from Kolaba up to Sivri, including major areas like Baikala, Tarde for that matter, it had less than 50% of the voter turnout. People did not really come out of their homes to vote. And here we are talking about 15 lakh eligible and registered voters, especially in South Mumbai constituency for that matter.
Okay.
We saw only senior citizens since morning coming out and voting. And obviously, to talk about the local issues, particularly at the forefront, because the candidates, they expect whichever political party come into power, they should address the issue of infrastructure development, they should address the issue of mehngai, is what they say. So all of these are certain issues, of course, people are really talking about.
Okay.
We'll try and see if there are voters. You can see that how the voters are going in right now. People with families, we also saw some first-time voters as well. If I can ask my video journalist Kapil to show you the queue at that point in time, we are not allowed to go inside because of the camera restrictions, Apoorva, but this is the kind of voter turnout. We'll try and speak to people out here. Hi, I think you've cast your vote. What are the issues that mainly you have voted for? Any one particular issue?
Can you please do this with somebody else? For progress, country's progress.
Country's
for development.
For how long you have been voting, ma'am? How many years?
Oh, so many.
Have you seen any change over the last couple of years, especially in your ward?
Yeah, change. There are positive changes.
So here, Apoorva, we are hearing, of course, some of the mixed reactions. This is the second polling center that we have come since morning, and people are only voting for development, for progress, and for change, whichever political party really comes to power. And lastly, I would really want to conclude this saying, in South Mumbai constituency, Worli is one of the important seats to look at, Apoorva, because Aditya Thackeray, the youth Shiv Sena leader, is going to contest for the very first time, bringing in forefront issues like having 24/7 nightlife in Mumbai, also to save the environment as far as the RA issue is concerned. All of these are the issues that the political parties have come to light. But as far as the voter turnout is concerned, in most of the locations, especially in South Mumbai, we have seen very less number of people coming out and to cast their vote.